What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode. Today, I got me a BougeRV. I think that's how you pronounce it. This is an electric cooler, freezer, I should say, because it does iced up. I have it right here, and I have been taking this thing on actually a couple of trips. 1 6-hour trip, and the other ones to, like, you know, an hour here, an hour there. Anyway, what I did was I actually hooked this one up to my car. Just, you know, the regular, you know, one of those cigarette lighter adapter. And then I also hooked it up to an external battery pack, an EcoFlow, that I have. You know, one of those emergency battery pack or ones that you take on camping. Yeah, so I took those out. I plugged that in. And then I also did a time lapse on this as well. So I'm going to show you guys that. But anyway, yeah, this is, I guess, my review on this BougeRV cooler. Let's go. Okay, so let's talk about this thing really quickly. It's very 2023-ish when you have one of these, okay? And this thing will keep your drink cold. And the noise level is not that noticeable when you're in the car. When this thing's running in the car, it's not that noticeable because the road noise is pretty loud. So there's no issue there. But if you're gonna be sleeping with this thing, yeah, you're gonna notice the noise. It's gonna be humming like a fridge, right? So that's one thing to keep in mind. This one right here can hold quite a bit of stuff. The reason why it can hold a lot of stuff is because you don't need ice in it, so it's not taking up any room at all. So yeah, you just put in your drinks or however you want it. Now realize something here, the more you put in, it won't get as cold as fast. So that's something to keep in mind as well. The more things you have in there, the longer it takes for it to make it cold. So when I did a time lapse on this, I did not have anything in the cooler. And so it took it exactly 1 hour for it to get down to -6 degrees. Think about that, -6 degrees, that's frozen stuff, right? But I didn't have anything in there. So if you do have stuff in there, it may not get all the way down to -6 degrees. And that is obviously with the house charger. Depending on how powerful your the device that you plug it into. So let's say if you plug it into a cigarette lighter in the car, it's not as powerful as the house plug. That's what I noticed. I'm not an electrician, so I don't know. But I noticed that the car cigarette lighter adapter doesn't pull enough power for this thing. So that's another takeaway that I would take from this. If you get one of these, maybe you should do like a converter. I have one of those converters. I just didn't use it that day, but consider doing that and plug this thing straight into, you know, the regular 2-3 prong so that it can power this thing effectively. But I used the cord that came with it to plug it straight into the car. It didn't get down that low. But then again, my cooler was full. I filled it up with drinks, and so it did not cool it down all the way like I wanted to, like -6. It got down to like 30, but that's about it. But that was a 6-hour road trip that I did. The car was on the whole time, by the way. It wasn't off and on, that kind of stuff. So yeah, that's kind of my experience with it. I felt like when I plug in the EcoFlow and use the regular plug for this instead of the car cigarette lighter adapter, it actually charges faster. Maybe it's the EcoFlow, I don't know. So the EcoFlow battery pack that I had, it says it can charge this thing at 18 hours. It can stay on for 18 hours, keep charging this thing. So it's pretty fantastic for, you know, having an external battery pack along with this on your camping trip. I think it's gonna power it all day long. And also, I mean, I don't wanna get into the EcoFlow, but the EcoFlow is fantastic because you plug that thing in and within an hour, it can fully charge that battery pack. If you're gonna get one of these, maybe you should consider getting an external battery pack that can power this thing because I feel like the car didn't power it as well. Even though it did, you know, it did do its job, but the problem with the car is that, you know, you turn it off and on as you're on the road trip, right? You know, you stop at a gas station and stuff like that to get gas, you're gonna turn it off. This thing will turn off, right? There's no battery in this thing at all. All right, so I've plugged this thing in. Let's talk about the feature of this thing really quickly. First off is that there isn't a battery pack in here. You already know that. You plug it in, it just turns on. That's it. The other thing is, this thing will automatically lock. Something that new owner, you should know, is that it automatically locks. You do have to hold this button down to unlock it, okay? In terms of how low it'll go, a negative 8 degrees Fahrenheit, that's how low it's going to go. And I'm gonna be quiet really quickly so you can actually hear how loud it is. So I mean, it's just humming, right? It's not really, I mean, my fridge is definitely a lot louder than this. Okay, so in terms of how big it is and how much drink you can load in here, I feel like it's sufficient for a road trip, four of us, plenty of room for it. Once again, you're not putting ice in here, so you're gonna have plenty of room for that. Okay, well there you go guys, that's my experience with this BougeRV. This is my first electric freezer, so I don't know. I haven't used any other one, I don't know, but I think this is a very like 2023 kind of thing, especially if you camp a lot. I think this is gonna be good because on the campsite, you're not gonna have ice, right? You don't wanna run out and get ice. So I think this is a good alternative to a cooler. It's just that you're gonna need constant power on this one, okay? Some of the campsite that I go to, it does have, a plug, a storage space with plugs. So it's good that I can plug this thing in and I don't have to use my battery pack. But anyway, that's it right there for me. That's my first impression, I guess, the light review of this. I hope you guys enjoy that. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.